السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Continue إن شاء الله تعالى with سورة قاف، and we'll go through إن شاء الله تعالى verses number 38 all the way to the end إن شاء الله, which is verse number 45. So from 38 in سورة قاف, سورة قاف سورة number 50. So if you can open the Mus'haf, inshallah, we'll start with the recitation and the Tajweed. Verse number 38. Repeat after me, inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Wa laqad khalaqna as-samawati wal-ard wa ma baynahuma fi sittati ayyamin wa ma massana min lughub. Wa laqad khalaqna, wa laqad, the dal is with qalqala, wa laqad خلقنا, and the قاف also, خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما في ستة أيام. تنوين after 12, then it's ضغام وغنة. وما مسنا مل وذار غنة مل لغوب, and the باء قلقل at the end. Next verse. فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. فاصبر, فا is light and then the صاد is heavy. فاصبي, and the باء with a kasra and the ra is light. فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل, the ba is qalqala, قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب, and the ba also at the end qalqala. Next verse, again Surah Qaf, Surah number 50, and we are in verse number 40. Verse number 40 in Surah Qaf. ومن الليل فسبحه وأدبار السجود. ومن الليل فسبحه. See the ha and the ha, they are close to each other where they're coming from. When the ha is lower than the ha comes from the bottom of your throat. So فسبحه. At the end, you just let the ear come out from the bottom of your throat. فَسَبِّحْهُ وَأَدْبَارَ, the dal is with qalqala, وَأَدْبَارَ, and then the ra is heavy, وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودَ, and the dal with the qalqala. Next ayah, 41. وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِي الْمُنَادِ مِنْ مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ. واستمع يوم ينادي المنادي من إدغام من مكان. The next one is إخفاء, من مكان قريب, and the ba at the end قلقلة. Next verse. يوم يسمعون الصيحة بالحق ذلك يوم الخروج. يوم يسمعون الصيحة بالحق ذلك يوم الخروج. نعم. Next verse. إنا نحن نحيي ونميت وإلينا المصير. إنا نحن نحيي ونميت وإلينا المصير. The sad is heavy. The next verse. يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير. يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا إخفاء سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير. And the last verse, نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار. نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار فذكر بالقرآن من يخاف وعيد. نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت إخفاء عليهم إخفاء عليهم بجبار another إخفاء فذكر بالقرآن من إدغام من يخاف وعيد. ولقد خلقنا آية number 38 ولقد خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما في ستة أيام وما مسنا من لغوب. And we did certainly create the heavens and earth and what is between them in 6 days and there touched us no weariness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informing us about his great power subhanahu wa ta'ala and his greatness subhanahu wa ta'ala and that his will is above all. That he subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created all of the creation. وَلَقَدَ خَلَقْنَا Indeed we created the heavens and the earth and what's between them. فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامِ And وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبِ And no weariness, no tiredness, nothing of that had touched Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unlike those who do not know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his perfect names and attributes, where they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rested on the day of Sunday, which is a lie. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how can the creator of the heavens and the earth get tired? As we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he decree a matter, he say kun, for it to be and it becomes. And these verses that talks about the power of Allah, something that a person should definitely reflect upon it with his heart. And then he would see that there is an effect. The effect of that is to submit oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To believe in Allah and the perfect names and attributes. And to show that in one's actions by submitting oneself to the creator of the heavens and the earth. Therefore the next verse, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ Be patient then over what they say. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ With praise and exalt and with praise of your Lord before the rising of the sun, before is its settings. So, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ Be patient, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, over what they say. What the disbelievers they say, ridiculing the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, denying the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, all these types of things. Be patient. And do what? What is the patient? What patience means? Patient means that you continue to do what you have been ordered to do and be patient with regards to what they say. And be busy with the remembrance of Allah. And that is the means to give the person steadfastness and strength to have the patience to oppose or to face those who oppose the orders of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. That's why he ordered the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make dhikr. To make tasbih in the beginning of the day and the end of the day. And the next verse says, وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْهُ وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ And in part of the night, exalt him and after prostration. right? Which is basically the five daily salah and the adhkar in the morning and in the evening, all of that is included. Because the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the tuma'nina, the tranquility and the calmness of the heart. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Those who believe and their hearts becomes tatma'in, in state of security and goodness by the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, in general, is the ibadah of Allah. And the salah is dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's something for us to think about, that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he say to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to do with regards to his enemies? And the surah was a Makki surah, right? Be patient over what they say and gain the strength by the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by making dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the five daily salah and so on. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْهُ وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِي الْمُنَادِي مِنْ مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ. And listen on the day when the caller will call out from a place that is near. وَاسْتَمِعْ, and listen. Listen with your heart the call of the caller, which is Israfil, the angel that is responsible for blowing on the trumpet to start the Day of Judgment. مِنْ مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ, from a near place. Near place from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's going to be near them, meaning it's going to happen for them to be resurrected. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ, the day they will hear the blast of the horn in truth, that is the day of emergence from the grave. So, وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِي مُنَادِي مِنْ مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَاسْتَمِعْ, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and O Muslims, O in the entire world, listen with your heart to what the caller is going to call from a very near place. You know, whether it's, as it's mentioned, somewhere on the earth, where he's going to be calling the people to be resurrected together, to be given life after death. يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ, when, on the day when they all would listen or would hear the blast, الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ, by the truth, there's no doubt about it. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ, this is the day of emergence, الخروج, where they would go out of their graves. And this is all by the power of Allah, the one that created them in the first place. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ نُحْيِي وَنُمِيتُ وَإِلَيْنَا الْمَصِيرُ. Indeed, it is we who give life and cause death, and to us is the destination. Because He subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that gave life and the one that gives death, so therefore, everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ الْأَرْضُ عَنْهُمْ سِرَاعًا ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. On the day the earth breaks away from them and they emerge rapidly, that is a gathering easy for us. Siraha, you know, they come out in rapidly, in haste to respond to the caller, the one that called them, and they would go to the gathering of the day of al-qiyamah. Thalika hashrun alayna yaseer, this is a gathering upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is yaseer, very easy, no tiredness, no difficulty. نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ, that means we are most knowing of what they say, meaning to the Prophet ﷺ, of what causes him to grieve and to be harmed from the harm what they saying. نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows the whims and what's even more secret than that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the Prophet ﷺ that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching everything, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is aiding him, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that guides, and he's the one subhanahu wa ta'ala that would make the truth to be established. So giving the comfort to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, so let your heart rejoice and be in state of tranquility and have the knowledge and the certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon you from better, even more than your own self. So there's what's left for you is to wait for the promise of Allah. is to do your job as a slave of Allah. And for the Prophet ﷺ, as a messenger of Allah, and convey the message, and the Prophet ﷺ conveyed it in the perfect way, and follow the way of the determined messengers of Allah from before, and wait for the promise of Allah. That's why it says, وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارٍ, which means you are not over them a tyrant. That means you're not a tyrant over them to force them, to overpower them. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُنْذِرٍ وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. You are nothing but a warner, and every nation has someone to guide them, to show them the truth. And then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدٍ. But remind by the Quran whoever fears my threat. So it's remind the people by the Quran. Remind them by reciting the Quran unto them. What does the Quran, what the Quran does to the people is that it takes them into their fitrah, into their pure nature. If they go to their pure nature and to their intellect and reason, they would see clearly the truth in the Quran. From the love of doing good, and from hating evil and staying away from it. And those who would benefit by the reminders, those who fear the threat of Allah. And as for those who fear the threat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they don't believe in it, right, there's not going to be benefit for them. But in the day of judgment, the justice will be served against them, and they won't have an excuse to say, well, we didn't receive the messenger, we did not receive the warning. You have been warned. So, and that's it's a call for those who call to Allah. Don't remind the people with your own beautiful speech and ways of doing things, but rather bil Quran, by the Quran, by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran that has the best ways of evidences and calling people to the truth. This is the end of the surah, and inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we'll go through the benefits that we learn from the surah. And we'll go through the meanings or the words now, inshallah. وَلَقَدْ and certainly, number 38. And as we said, قَدْ certainly, but you add the lam to it, that's lamu التَّوْكِيد, more stress. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا, خَلَقْنَا, we created. خَلَقَ, and then na, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created. السَّمَاوَاتْ, the heavens, comes, the root of it is seen, mim waw. Anything that is above. السماوات, the plural, in plural, والأرض, and the earth. وما, and whatever, or بينهما, whatever between both of them, and that's باء ياء نون, في ستة أيام, in six, ستة, you know, it's like سين تاء تاء, في ستة أيام, days, and one is يوم. وَمَا مَسَّنَا, and مَسَّ is touch, from meme seen seen. مَسَّنَا touched us, and مَا is negating. So nothing touched us. مِن لغوب, any fatigue or tiredness or weariness, from لَمْ غِيمْ بَا. And مِن لغوب, that means nothing whatsoever. Not even, if it says مَا مَسَّنَا لغوب, if لغوب never touched us, it's weaker than وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوب. That means no whatsoever weariness or tiredness or fatigue afflicted us. And لَغَبَ, again, comes from the meaning of someone is hungry and tired. And that's, you know, the root of it. And it comes with many different meanings linguistically. Someone that is not intellect, things like this. فَصْبِرْ, so be patient. Therefore, the fa is, therefore be patient. إِصْبِرْ, it's an order from صَاد بَأْرَاء. عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ, over what they say, يَقُولُونَ, from قَفْ وَأُولَمْ. وَسَبِّحْ, and make تَسْبِيح, and glorify, from سِين بَأْحَاء. بِحَمْدِ, by the, or the praise, بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكْ, your Lord. قَبْلَ, before, طُلُوع, rising, from طَلَعَ, طَأْلَمْعِينَ, come out, or here is rising. قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ, الشَّمْسِ is the sun, and that's the same three letters of it. وَقَبْلَ, and before, الْغُرُوبِ, the setting, from غِينْ رَأْ بَأْ, which is the sunset. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ, and from the night, اللَّيْلِ, فَسَبِّحْهُ, glorify him, And the ha refers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa adbar, adbar and after comes from dal ba ra dubur. And after, and dubur comes in two meanings, after and at the end of. It depends on the context and it depends on the actions. Wa adbar as-sujud and after the prostrations from sajada. Wastami' and listen. And the sujood, of course, can be called prostration, and it refers to the salah, and that's what it means. Wastami' and listen from sin mim ma'in. Wastami' yawma yunadi munadi. On the day yunadi will call from noon dal waw. Noon dal waw, that's the root of it. Al munadi is the caller, from, you know, the one that calls. Mim makanim ba'id. Min makanin qarib, from a makan or a place, kaf wa nun, qarib, qarib is near, from qaf ra ba. Yawma yasma'una as-sayha, on the day when they yasma'una will hear from sin mim ain as-sayha. As-sayha, as we heard, is the blast, and comes from sad ya ha. And saha fulan, that means fulan shouted. And it's usually something that is a cry or a high, you know, with loud voice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best how great that blessed is. Bilhaq, in the truth, from ha, qaf, qaf. Thalika yawm al-khuruj, this is the day of coming forth, from kha, ra, jim. Inna nahnu, indeed we, nuhi wa numit, nuhi from ha, ya, ya, wa numit, and cause death or make death. From mim waw ta, wa ilayna al-masir, and to us is al-masir. Al-masir from sad ya ra, meaning the return. And comes from the, al-masir is the return, of course. And you would have many words that, you know, even in the Quran, al-masir, tasir, to Allah, you know, the end of things. Yawma, on the day, tashakkaku, will split from sheen qaf qaf. Al-ardu, the earth, anhum sira'a, from them sira'a, rapidly hurrying from sin ra'ain, like wasari'u, be in haste. Thalika, hashrun, a gathering, the same three letters, alayna yasir. Yasir means easy, from ya sin ra'. Nahnu a'lamu, we know best, bima, with what they yaqulun, what they say. Wama anta alayhim, over them bijabbar. Jabbar is tyrant, to compel them, to force them, from jim ba'ra. Al-jabr is to be forced. Wama anta alayhim bijabbar. Fadhakkir, so therefore remind, dhakkir, bil-Quran, with the Quran, may yakhafu wa'id, the one that khaf from kha wa wafa. Wa'id. Wa'id is my threat from wa'ada, which is also the promise. So wa'id is in the threat sense, and wa'ada is the promise. So we'll stop here, inshallah ta'ala. Barakallahu feekum wa sallallahu sallam baraka Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.